So just my background real quickly. I have a master's in education, administration, curriculum, supervision, and policy from the University of Oklahoma. I've been in education for about 6 years, working as an educator, as a consultant, which I currently do right now. New teacher coach, and also like an athletic coach. I've coached field hockey, soccer, football, currently coaching basketball, as well as, you know, debate and Model UN. So I've a plethora of experiences, not only from the education sense, but also coaching. Currently, I'm a special education consultant and math specialist at King Abdullah Academy, which is one of the elite Islamic schools in the United States. And it's a school that serves, you know, embassy kids, but just kids, Islamic kids in general. And then on top of that, I'm also a consultant for Adam Center. Many of you might have heard of Adam Center. It's one of the largest masjids, not only in Virginia, but in the United States. So I'm an education consultant for them, as well as the principal for one of their Sunday school branches. So that's why, you know, unfortunately, Sunday is no longer available for me, as I was able to teach previously. But my schedule has filled up a little bit. And alhamdulillah, you know, I'm using Salesforce now on a day-to-day basis, because all our system, all our data for the Sunday school that I'm in charge of, we keep in Salesforce, right? From the student records to the parent records, to see who's paid, you know, who hasn't paid, even the grades, you know, see what students are making progress or not making progress, all that stuff. We monitor in Salesforce. So Salesforce is like an all-in-one system, right? Traditionally, Salesforce was seen as only a system for salespeople, right? But now, you know, we're not in the sales business, right? We're in the education business, but we're using Salesforce just as effectively as someone who's in the sales business, right? So as you'll learn throughout the class, Salesforce is a multi-tiered system, and it has a lot of uses. So that's why it's very popular. Nowadays, you're seeing a lot of, you know, CRMs like Monday.com, Red Writing, a couple other ones, right? You see them on YouTube, or you see them, really pop up. But Salesforce is still the number one, because it's an all-in-one system. It's easy to use. It's user-friendly. You'll be able to create that. You'll see, like, you might not have any development skills, but you'll be able to create an app, you know, very, very easy and very effective app, you know, inshallah. And you'll see why people use Salesforce, because it's so user-friendly. Okay, so inshallah, just like Brother Ahmed was saying, class will be from Saturdays from 9 to 11, inshallah. And then Wednesdays, we change the time from 7 to 9 instead of 8 to 10. So 7 to 9 p.m. Please follow along closely, as this is an interactive class in which students will be actively doing what I'm doing, right? So when I'm creating those apps and I'm creating those tabs, right? And I'm creating, you know, those S objects, you know, I want you to do it with me, right? And again, you know, I sometimes do have a tendency of going a little fast. If I am going fast, please, 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 just pause. Be like, Instructor Khizr, can you please say that again? Oh, I'm not with you. Can you show me how to do that step, right? Because, you know, the best way to learn the system, for me, like I said, I've only been doing it for about like a year and a half, 2 years. I've learned it by doing it, right? By practicing it. Now I'm doing it on a daily basis for the Sunday school. But before that, the best way that I learned was not through lecture, not through listening to somebody tell me about it, but it was to actively doing it, right? And then later on, as we prepare for the Salesforce exam, I'm going to introduce you to a website. Some of you might already know. It's called Trailhead. And that's another interactive way. That's the best way that I've felt, that I've learned, right? It goes module by module, shows you exactly what you need to know for the administrator exam, but not only from a practical, not only from a theoretical standpoint, but from a practical standpoint, right? So it's going to tell you, okay, this is how you create the S objects. This is how you configure a report, right? And it's going to allow you to prove that. So you, every time you move on to a different module, you have to successfully complete what they've tell you. And then inshallah, not today, but starting next class on Wednesday, homework will be given. So inshallah, today we're just going to, like I said, talk about what Salesforce is, what CRM is, and then build our developer account, you know, and then starting on Wednesday, you know, we're going to hit the ground running. We're going to create, like I said, apps, tabs, and you'll see right away, this class is going to pick up, inshallah, very quickly. It's going to be very hands-on. So like Brother Ahmed was saying, it's very, very important that, you know, you're following along and you're doing it too, because if you're not doing it, you're not going to learn, right? Before I move on, does anybody have any question about how the class will work? And again, please feel free to ask questions. Let's see. Can everybody see the syllabus?
Yes.
Okay, alhamdulillah. Like Brother Ahmed was saying, it's an 8-week class, about 32 hours, and it's divided into four subjects, right? So we have the introduction, which is going to be like today and a little bit of Wednesday. So then we'll go into the configuration side of it, right? How do we understand master detail relationship, self lookup, roll-up summary, pick list, global pick list, you know? There's a lot of things. One thing about Salesforce is there's a lot of vocabulary. So it's very important. You know, I'm going to go over all this stuff in detail with you guys. You'll see it. But it's very important that you're practicing it so you understand the difference between a global pick list and just a normal pick list, right? There's a huge difference between those. And when you use a global pick list versus when you use a multi-select pick list, right? Configuration also includes page layouts, right? Record types. So how am I going to make my app in Salesforce look unique, right? Compared to any other app, right? So you have the ability to formulate how you want your app to look, how you want your record types to look, what type of data you want to store. So it's a lot of work on the end user's part, right? So that all falls under configuration. Then we have the CRM, you know, marketing, which I think Sister Zaina, sorry, I think I'm, can you say your name one more time? Sister Janae was talking about, you know, entering in data, following leads, you know, tracking clients, closing leads, right? All that stuff. That's on the marketing side, and we'll talk about, inshallah, a little bit about that as well. But the majority of the class is going to focus on the configuration, right? But we'll still talk about CRM marketing. Then we'll go into the admin side of it, right? This is what, you know, you'll do on a day-to-day basis, right? Creating dashboards, creating reports, approving users, right? Giving users access. So when somebody is new to your company, you have to sign them up, right? You have to give them certain access. You're not going to give everybody the same access. For example, the salesperson is not going to have the same access as the developer, right? Because they have different jobs, they need different things, right? So how do you give certain access to the salesperson, but limit those access to the developer, right? That's going to be your job as an admin, understanding the hierarchy, you know, who's able to approve what, right? Workflows, process builders, you know, all that stuff is all falls under the admin. So the admin is a very expensive job. But again, it's a job that, inshallah, if you learn, you know, workflows and you learn what apps are and what tabs are. So that's why it's important. The way that I teach the classes, I want you guys to actually develop an app and understand what the tab is, what the object is, how to enter records, right? So if you have that background knowledge, then going into the admin part of it is going to be very easy because you understand how the system works. And now it's about, you know, you manipulating the system to use your to meet the end user's needs, which is your company, right? When you're in the admin position, your company's going to have XYZ. This is what I need, XYZ. Now it's up to you to do those deliverables, right? How do you do the deliverables? For example, how do you create flows? How do you create a process builder, right? Inshallah, those are stuff that we will learn. So if you've been, like some of you in this class have been familiar with Salesforce, you probably know some of these vocabulary. And some of those people that have already taken a Salesforce class, a lot of this might look familiar to you, but again, it never hurts to, you know, review and really practice upon some of these skills. So inshallah, before, does anybody have any question about the syllabus? I can also, inshallah, email it to you guys if you would like.
Yes, yeah. that would be great.
Okay, so inshallah, once the class is over, I'll go ahead and email it to you. So that was just a quick overview of the syllabus, inshallah. So. All right, so back to, okay, so before we get into Salesforce, right? Traditionally, what were traditional software systems, right? So clients and development companies need to what? They need to upgrade, maintain, install, right? All the time, you know, because technology is moving at the speed of light. So it's always changing. So it was costing people a lot of money. And so that's where Salesforce comes in, right? How do you overcome this? We went to the cloud concept, right? Cloud computing. Before, people had physical places like physical data centers, right? Or physical places where they had their computers and it would just cost them a lot of money, right? And they would store their data. So what did people do about this? The idea of cloud computing. Has anybody heard of the cloud? Like, for example,
yeah. No, actually, yeah. No.
Yes. Oh.
Not me.
Not you? Okay. So if somebody who's heard of the cloud, can you explain from your
understanding? Is cloud like a storage?
Yeah, it is. Yeah, it is a little bit.
Okay.
I think it's just like yeah, go ahead.
Like iCloud, and is that, am I on the right track? Like
no, you're on the right path.
Okay, and I know my Microsoft Windows has a cloud, like
yeah, Microsoft Cloud, yeah, Google Cloud.
Google Cloud.
Yeah, so these are all companies that that allow you to store and use like database in the cloud, right? Instead of having a physical location, right, where the system is always running and you're costing a lot of money, you just pay for what you use, right? So if you're only going to use X amount of data for a month, you're only going to pay the X amount of data. Versus in a physical setting, you know, you're paying regardless of whether you're using it or not, because you have to maintain the machines, right? You have to maintain all those operations. You have to maintain employees, right? So the cloud allows you to, you know, cut off all those costs, right? And just pay for what you need. So essentially, it is a concept / technology where we will get all IT services like hardware or software over the internet and access to those services, right? The practice of using a network of remote. This is the key part, right? Of remote, right? Servers hosted on the internet to store, manage, and process data rather than a local or personal computer, right? Rather than having something on base, on premise, you have it stored in the cloud, right? You have it accessed to you when you need it, and you just pay for it when you use it, versus keeping a physical computer in the database, right? So that's what I want you guys to understand. If somebody asks you what cloud is, it's stored, right? It's not physical, right? It's stored all in a system, and you pay for it as you use it, right? Whether it's, you know, your iPhone, when you take the pictures, it's stored in the cloud, right? Versus, you know, you storing it in your laptop. You know, so that's essentially the biggest difference, and it's very cost effective. And Salesforce is the number one CRM, cloud computing as well, CRM database in the world. So we have three different ways, right? The cloud works three different ways. We have IaaS, PaaS, and SaaS, right? We have infrastructure as a service, we have platform as a service, and we have software as a service. Salesforce falls under platform as a service, right? It's a platform that people use to store their data, to store their leads, to generate their data, to track how their company is doing. Are they meeting revenue growth? Are they not meeting revenue growth, right? So the cloud falls under these three concepts. And for Salesforce, the one that you guys need to focus on is platform as a service, right? So what else is a platform as a service, for example? Can you guys think of another platform as a service outside of Salesforce? So I can give you a hint. For example, what do you guys use to track your email?
Facebook?
Not necessarily. Yeah. I think of it more as from a software perspective. Or from a data perspective, data perspective.
Is one called Workday or something like that?
Yeah, that's definitely a platform as a service, right? So where you store your emails, right? Where you communicate, where you have team meetings, right? So for example, Microsoft has Outlook. Google has Gmail, right? Yahoo has theirs, and then Oracle has theirs, right? These are the places where you use to communicate with fellow workmates, store data. So think about it as a place that you could, a system that you can use to help generate business, right? To help you do your job on a day-to-day basis as like a salesperson, right? Sister Janae, right? You probably use, what do you use outside of Salesforce? You probably use Microsoft Teams, right? To communicate?
Yes, Microsoft Teams. We use that for communication, mm-hmm. Putting information like announcements and asking questions.
Yeah, so that's a platform as a service.
Oh.
Yep. Okay, so now let's get into Salesforce. So you guys understand that Salesforce is the two things I want you to understand. It's cloud-based and it's a platform as a service, okay? So what is Salesforce on top of that? Salesforce is a cloud-based software that helps organizations to effectively streamline their sales and marketing operations. Today, Salesforce is the number one customer relationship management, and we're going to talk about CRM a little bit more in the world, right? Companies use it for marketing, sales, commerce, service, and collaboration. It offers organizations easy access to web-based software over the internet, right? So it's a one-stop shop for everything. To generate your leads, store your leads, create reports, track new leads, work with outside companies, right? You can do all of it in Salesforce. So initially when Salesforce was created, it was just meant for salespeople, right? It was just meant to track leads and follow up on leads, right? Now, again, it's meant to store data. It's meant to, you know, create reports, right? You couldn't do all that maybe like 10, 15 years ago on Salesforce. You could only just track leads and follow up on leads, right? And they've really expanded it to where you can do everything. Like, you don't need 3 or 4 different software systems or platform systems. Salesforce does it all. And that's why Salesforce is very, very lucrative and very, a lot of jobs are in demand, right? If you go on Indeed, let's go on Indeed right now. Let me show you guys. So if you go on Indeed, right? If you type in Indeed, and you type in Salesforce, all right, you'll see hundreds of jobs pop up, even in this area, right? Ashburn, Salesforce Administrator. Pretty much every major company in the world needs a Salesforce Administrator and needs multiple Salesforce Administrators. Like, obviously, if you're a small-time company, one will do. But, like, if you're a company like Nike or, like, Costco or some of those bigger companies, you're going to need multiple Salesforce Administrators, right? And look at the salaries, up to 100,000, 100 and 130,000, right? It's a very lucrative job, and it's not like a job that you need a lot of coding for, not a lot of you know, technical skills, but it's a job that if you understand how the system works and how you're able to manipulate the system, it's a job that you can easily pick up and easily do. It pays really well. So like this, like you can go on Indeed, Monster, any of the job search sites, and type in Salesforce Administrator, and you'll find hundreds, if not thousands, of results. Right? Yeah. So over here, these are thousands of results all over the country. And a lot of the good thing is that there's a lot of remote jobs for these. So if you type in remote, right, you'll find a lot of these jobs. You can work from home, right? You don't need to necessarily even go into the office to do this type of job. So this is another benefit of understanding Salesforce and understanding the system. And again, if you guys ever want to create your own company or your own business, the best way to track your expenses, the best way to communicate with potential clients and customers is using Salesforce. And again, inshallah, towards the end of this class, we're going to create a Salesforce developer account, which is free. So like, you can create your own company and have your own app and start creating your own S objects and your own tabs and things of that nature right away, right? You can do it, inshallah, once you learn this and you feel like having a business idea and you want something and you want a place to track it, you can do it for free on Salesforce, right? Obviously, if you want a little bit more of the features, you pay, which we're going to talk about the different additions of Salesforce. But again, you can essentially create your own organization within Salesforce for free and track your leads and track your revenue, track your expenses, all that, right? And I'm going to show you, inshallah, the Salesforce that I use and how I use it so that it makes a little bit more sense. So inshallah, let me go back to, okay. So it offers organizations easy access to web-based software over the internet. So does anybody have any questions about essentially what Salesforce is? Do you have an understanding of what it is?
For me, I'm good, brother.
Anybody else have any, like, you want to know anything?
You explain it in the easy way and sample way, actually.
Alhamdulillah. Okay, career opportunities, right? It's saying the admin average is 97,000, but as I was showing you on Indeed, right, most of the jobs were starting at, what, 100,000, 120,000. So I think this might even be a little old. There's going to be 3.3 new million Salesforce jobs by 2023, okay? So that's not just admin. That's also Salesforce developer, Salesforce consultant, Salesforce engineers, right? So there's 3.3 million jobs in Salesforce in general. And I would say out of those 3.3 million, at least close to 500,000 to a million of them are admin or something to do with admin. So inshallah, you guys are in good hands. All right, Salesforce clouds, right? So the Salesforce has three different type of clouds, right? So it has the marketing cloud. So this is so if you're a marketing company and you just want to use Salesforce for marketing, you're going to use the marketing cloud, right? If you're a sales company and you only want to use Salesforce for sales purely, you're going to use the sales cloud, right? And if you're a service company, you're going to use the service cloud, right? all together, you can use all three, or you can only use whatever, whichever one you need, right? Salesforce is very friendly. Salesforce is very user friendly in that sense that you use what you want, what you need, right? If you need more, you use more. If you need less, you use less, right? And again, the idea of CRM, right? Customer relationship management. There's many of them out there now. Like I was saying, Monday.com, Red Hood. There's, like, if you Google CRMs, you'll find hundreds of thousands, right? But Salesforce continues to topple all of them because it's so user friendly and it's very accessible, right? Like I was telling you, for the job that I'm doing right now as a consultant, we're not in the sales business. Obviously, we require tuition of the students, but we have much more than that. Like, it tracks their information, it tracks their allergies, right? It tracks their learning goals. If somebody has an IEP, for example, individualized education plan, right? Somebody might have a learning disabilities. We can track all that and store all that in Salesforce, right? And I can just pull it up. Okay, this student has an IEP. When we're going to give him an exam, he needs 5 minute breaks in between whatever, right? Whatever the situation would be, right? Before, no other CRM platform really does that. They usually just focus on sales and tracking customer leads. But what makes Salesforce unique is that it goes beyond that. And that's why it's really popular. And I believe it's going to, at least for the next 10, 15 years, I'll be the most popular CRM out there. Okay. So from current slide. Okay.
I have a question.
Yep.
All right. So how does it compare to something like Epic? Is it the communication part that makes it different? Because they all store information.
Yeah. But also, I don't think Epic has necessarily the best ways to display dashboards, display reports, and then have within Salesforce, you can also have meetings within your own team. You can have, we have a chat box, a chat feeder, which you can communicate within different teams and different departments. So I think the biggest thing between Epic and Salesforce is the ability to present those reports and present those findings in an easy and logical way, you know?
Yes, that makes sense. Thank you. Also, somebody had a question in the chat. What was Salesforce consultant versus admin? And I had a similar question about what's the difference between an admin developer and an engineer, but I'll look that part up later.
No. Yeah. So what an admin does, right? Again, he or she is the one that's providing the day-to-day support for the Salesforce, keeping it running in that sense, right? Who has certain accesses? When somebody leaves the company, make sure that you remove those accesses, right? So they don't have access to certain information that they don't need, right? Assigning roles, assigning case, creating reports, right? That's an admin's role. What an engineer does is that he designs the app, right? He designs the specific app to, okay, this is how I want it to be formulated. These are the objects that I want. This is how I want my data to be recorded. So for example, a company will give the engineer a list of certain criteria that they want their app to look like, or they want their Salesforce platform to look like. And it's the engineer's job to create that based on what the company wants, right? The admin then has to really, on a day-to-day basis, you know, update the information, make sure that it's up to standards, that the reports are being created. So the developer, he develops the app. The admin really takes care and nurtures the system, if that makes sense.
It does. Thank you very much. And yep. The consultant
finds ways to effectively use Salesforce, right? Or how you can use it more to, you know, leverage sales, or what's the best way to, you know, market it? What's the best way to what system you should use? Like, for example, should you use we're going to go over that a little bit. Enterprise system, should you use the basic system? What does your company need? So how you can really optimize it, right? So that's the job of the consultant, is to make sure you are optimizing Salesforce to the best of your ability so that you're getting the most sales, or you're gaining what you need out of it.
Thank you, sir.
Yep. So we went over this. Okay. CRM. Okay. Customer relationship management, which is equal to marketing, sales, and service. The goal of a CRM is to retain the existing customers and grab the new customers into our business. How to retain existing services, just like anything else, right? Provide good service. And that's what Salesforce does. Okay. This is what I was talking about, right? So you have different types of Salesforce, right? You have the essentials, you have the professionals, you have the enterprise, and you have the unlimited, right? And based on what you need and based on how big your company is and what the requirements of your company are, you're going to pick, right? The prices are $25 a month for essentials, $75 for a professional, Enterprise is 150 and unlimited is 300. But the one that I use for my company is Essentials, because we're not necessarily using it for sales, right? We're not necessarily using it for marketing, none of that stuff. We're just using it to track data, make sure that our operations are in check, make sure that, you know, payments are being made, kids' data is being stored, their parents' data is being stored. So we only need the essential, right? For example, somebody like Nike will probably use the unlimited, right? They need a lot of data. They need a lot of information. They need to create a lot of leads, right? So again, the size of your company and what your company needs really determines the type of addition that you're going to purchase, right? So yeah, again, the less you need, the less you pay, the less you pay, the more you need, the more you pay. And this would probably be an exam question on the admin exam. There's a lot of questions on the admin exam, unfortunately, that don't necessarily have to do with the job, but I guess they want you to understand the system, right? They want you to understand, like, okay, what is Salesforce? Are you able to have a conversation? If you were to go into a Salesforce meeting, can you at least understand the lingo, right? Understand what's going on, the conversation, be able to have an educated conversation about the system, right? So you'll find out throughout the class, there's going to be a lot of things that you might think to yourself, like, as an admin, I might never do on a day-to-day basis, but it's still important to understand, right? These are one of those things. On top of that, there are three. So every year, Salesforce upgrades, right? So during the winter season, they have a winter version. During the spring season, they have a spring version. And the summer season, they have a summer version, right? And again, they don't change too much. They just change little things here and there. Currently, we're in the winter season. So they just, I think, maybe a week ago, maybe 2 weeks ago, just updated from the spring, from the summer to the winter edition. And then around April-ish, May time, they'll go to the spring edition. And every year they're just changing a few things, a few niches, you know, a few different ways here and there. It's not, you won't really notice it unless you're looking for it, right? So if you're doing Salesforce in the winter, it's pretty much going to look like the same thing as you're doing it in the spring, as you're doing it in the summer, right? Unless you're like really looking for those minute little changes, you won't notice it. And more so, I think the developers are the ones that really notice those changes. As an admin, Salesforce is Salesforce, right? It's a pretty easy system to use. Once you understand the, you know, the ins and outs of it, it doesn't matter. You know, you can use it, you know. All right. So inshallah, we'll go ahead and we'll create one, but I think we'll take a break. So we'll be back at let's say 10. Let's go 10:25. We'll be back, and inshallah, this is the one I want you to, if you have a monitor, please follow along. As I'm going to show you how to create your own account, and we'll create our own account, and we'll create our first app, inshallah. So at 10:25, inshallah, 15 minutes. Everybody, be back, and please be ready to create your own account, inshallah. Okay, so if you go into Salesforce, right? This is the one that I use, right? I'm part of the Adam Center organization, and the way that they've laid it out. Right. These are the various tabs. Right. They have accounts, contacts, opportunities, academic sessions, program registrations, classes, groups. And so within Adam Center, there's multiple education programs. Right. There's one for their main branch in Sterling. There's one for their branch in Gainesville and Ashburn. Right. I'm in charge of the one in Leesburg. And within that, so they have a big Salesforce platform, and then they have a Salesforce for every specific branch education program that they offer. Right. And so the one that I'm a part of is Leesburg, right? And the way that they've broken it down is they've broken it down into accounts, right? So if you go to recently, no, go to recently accounts. Let me go. Let's start with actually context. So I'm able to find out all of my students.
Would you like us to go to the developer salesforce.com?
Not at the moment. Just give me 1 second. I'm just showing you how it looks before you, so that you guys have an idea when you create your own. Then when we create it together, inshallah. So right, these are all the students, right? That are enrolled in this Sunday school program, and who their parent is, their parents' email, where they live, and if they've paid, right? So I have different opportunities tabs. Are these are potential people that we could potentially look into bringing into our program that are in other Adam Center programs, but they live in Leesburg, right? So these are the ones that are currently enrolled. These are the ones that could potentially be enrolled. We have broken down into academic sessions. We haven't necessarily So we have like six different classes, right? We have one for our preschool. So this is our preschool class. We have one for our kindergarten class, for kindergarten first grade class, second, third grade class, fourth, fifth, and then our sixth grade class. We have another tab that that tells us our registration. So all the students that have registered into our program, it's broken down like really beautifully, really nice, really neatly. Like it's easy to understand. Even if somebody who doesn't necessarily understand Salesforce can look at this and understand, okay, how to navigate this, right? Well, so for example, in order, these are things that we're going to create. Like, for example, in order to enroll in preschool, or sorry, in order to enroll in our Sunday school program, the minimum age a child has to be is 4 years old, right? There's a formula that you create that we're going to talk about, inshallah. And some of the students that have already taken Salesforce with me previously, they know what I'm talking about, right? We're going to create a formula that allows that, that has an eligibility requirement, for example, right? For this one, students can only enroll, or parents can only enroll students that are 4 years old or that are 12 years old, that are between 4 to 12 years old, right? So if, for example, a student is 3 years old, automatically the registration will not work, right? Because they don't meet that requirement. Or if a student is 13 years old, he or she is not able to enroll, right? So Salesforce gives you a lot of that flexibility to really design the system the way that you want to, right? For example, we also have payment fees. Where's the payment? Let me see more. I'll show you. Fee structures. Yep. Fee structures. Okay. So this person, for example, is a user, right? And he has to pay, he is a member. So he gets a discounted rate. So he only pays $80 for his registration fee, versus if you're not a member of Adam Center, you pay $120. So you're able to formulate Salesforce to allow different criteria based on when you register. Again, breaking down into classes and groups. So this is sixth grade, fifth grade, fourth grade, third grade. So I can just click on it. Right away, I know how many students are in each grade. So in third grade, for example, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 kids enrolled, right? I know their parents. So for example, if I have an emergency, I need to contact so-and-so's parents, I can just click right here, right? I have all their information, their address, everything, right? So this is like traditionally Salesforce, like I was saying, was just meant for sales and to track leads. But now you can store all sorts of information in this database. It's a very, very powerful database that allows you to do multiple things, not just, you know, track leads, not just close leads or marketing, right? It allows you to do things like run a Sunday school, run an ordinary business, right? That has nothing to do with necessarily sales, right? Or even like, for example, a lot of medical records are also being stored in Salesforce. So a lot of the hospitals, they're transitioning over to Salesforce because it's so easy for, you know, nurses who might not necessarily have a technical background to understand, to understand how to, you know, store data. They can easily just store it here, right? Because it's very, very easily laid out. And this is the job of the developer, right? So the client is going to tell the developer, we want a tab for accounts. We want a tab for contacts. We want a tab for opportunities, right? We need a tab for academic sessions. And can you please create those? And within those tabs, we need subsections, right? So we need like program name. So over here, ours is not as intensive, but like look at this, right? These are the various subsections within the section, right? So we need their name, first name, middle name, last name, contact record, their birth date, their phone, right? These are all things that, inshallah, we're going to create in a minute, right? Or we're going to create throughout this class for our scenarios. So does anybody have any questions just looking at this? Like, do you need any other explanations about like how Salesforce works before we...
You mentioned the communication portion, like there's notes or how do you communicate?
Yeah, so send an email list, right? Like, so I want to send all my all the parents, I want to send them the email list. So now, right, for example, like, say, for example, dear parents, I'm not going to actually send it, right? Dear parents, next week we will start school later, right? And then I can just send it. Now, all the people that are within my system, right, all the parents that are within my system, once I send it, they'll receive that email right away, right? So I can those are the people that are in my system that I need to communicate with, right? So they have that. I can also have MailChimp. You know, I don't know if you guys, if you've ever worked in a political campaign, the way that they get your information is through MailChimp, right? So they know, okay, so-and-so has voted Democrat the last X amount of years, right? It's a good idea. We go market to him, so he might vote for us, right? Because we're a Democratic candidate or vice versa, right? So that's where the MailChimp comes in. So there's different ways to communicate to your stakeholders, to your people within organizations, and people within other organizations. Does that answer your question?
Perfectly. Thank you.
Yeah, no problem. Any other questions before we create our account? Yeah, go ahead, ask questions, inshallah. I want you guys to make sure you guys understand how Salesforce works. And so everybody, yeah, go ahead.
If we want to create a Salesforce account, do we have to download the software?
No. We're about to do that actually in like... There's a link that I sent on the PowerPoint that we're going to do it together, inshallah, in a minute, right after this. And it's very easy. You don't have to download anything.
Sure.
Okay, awesome. I wanted to show you guys one other thing. So these are the tabs that are shown, right? I don't have the ability to manipulate it because I'm not the admin. I just use it. But if I was the admin, I could, like, for example, these things, I wanted them to appear over here. I could manipulate that, right? And other people have done that in our classes, right? When we create our own apps. So if I want to leave requests instead of accounts, right, to show here, I can have leave requests over here, right? I can have pick up permissions over here, right? So these are Salesforce really allows me to customize my application the way that I want it, the way that I see fit, the way that the company sees fit, right? So again, this is another thing I want you to look at, right? And then after this, inshallah, we'll get to it. So this is probably one of the most important jobs as an admin, is to create reports, right? So for example, like monthly report, let's look at this. So I'm showing you guys like the ins and outs of Salesforce, right? Like, so for example, this month, right? Our program generated $15,906.22, right? It shows us exactly who paid and when they paid or when they're scheduled to pay for December. Let's look at October for November, right? So the way we have our system set up is that the payment happens on the 15th of every month, okay? So the 15th of every month, it's automatically going to charge your credit card, right? And for example, if somebody might not have funds on their credit card or they change their credit card, right, and it doesn't go through, we'll get a message that says, oh, so-and-so's payment didn't go through, right? Even Salesforce has the ability to track that. So these are the reports. Like this shows you how much, who's paid, how much money we've generated for our program, what we're like designed to generate. Record by record, right? So this person, how much they've paid, this person, how much they've paid, record by record. Like it's literally breaks it down so easy for anybody, like a novice, to really understand the system. And people that have used it, they can attest to that. Like it's very easy to pick up, very easy, very user friendly. So yeah, inshallah. So just to give you an idea, so these are the reports. For example, this is the monthly report. Let me show you a couple other reports. So this is what I was talking about, right? All failed payments. So we have one, right? So for the month of October, sorry, the month of August, right? This is before I was even a part of this. This payment didn't go through, right? So it's my job. I unfortunately have to do it soon. I have to reach out to this person and be like, okay, the month of August, your payment didn't go through, right? You still owe us $30.52, right? Because your payment, for whatever reason, your credit card didn't go through. But everybody else, alhamdulillah, you know, went through, right? So it shows you, okay, this person's payment didn't go through. Student algae, right? Yeah. So we have 17 records, okay? So-and-so has algae, like. So this shows you student by student. So, okay, like, for example, this student right here, right? What is she allergic to? Nuts, right? So I hope you guys really understand how user-friendly it is, how easy it is. Just to access any type of information that you want, right? Pretty much. And then this is
so bright and easy to access information.
Yeah, really is. That's why it's such a useful system. And this is probably the last thing I'll show you, inshallah. All successful payments. Hopefully I click on the right one. Let's see. Yeah. So these are all the payments that are that. So out of all the students that are registered, only one failed to pay, right? So we have 193 successful payments and one failed payment, right? So it's my job to go, track that person down, inshallah. I'll do that soon. But these are all the successful payments, right? It shows you the status paid. On the date they paid, the amount they paid, right? The monthly amount they paid, et cetera. So inshallah, now that you guys have an understanding of, Salesforce in real life, right? Let's go ahead and inshallah create our own Salesforce account. So if you go to the PowerPoint that I sent, go ahead and copy and paste this link. So it's developer.salesforce.com/free-trial.
Could I probably put it in the chat?
No, absolutely.
Yeah. I just did.
Awesome. Let me go ahead and put it for the chat for other people.
Thank you.
Yep. Paste. So inshallah, it's in the chat. So once you get in the chat, go ahead and open up the link. So I'm going to log out of this one, right? I'm going to create a new one with you guys. So I'm going to do everything with you guys. So I'm going to go ahead and log out of this one. And as you can see,
I have a little request. Can you go here a little slow, please?
Yeah, I will. Absolutely. Okay, so but let me know once everybody's on this page, please.
Yes, I am.
Yes, okay. Other people, please. So
I'm here.
I'm here. Awesome. Okay. All right, so I'm going to go, inshallah, go on. So I want you guys to scroll down a little bit. It says feature trial, Salesforce Developer Edition. Build enterprise cloud apps and test functionality with this full featured Salesforce edition, okay? Go ahead and just click sign up. Okay, go ahead and provide your information, okay? So I'm gonna use the ImpactTek email because I already have a couple accounts. So they won't let you do it again with the same email. So if you've done this class or similar class, previously, you try to use a different email, otherwise it won't work.
If we have Gmail, is it better to use that? I don't know if future we will need that, like Google Apps or anything like that.
No, yeah, it doesn't matter. You can use any email. The only reason, make sure you have access to the email though, because it's going to send you a verification. It's going to ask you to verify your job role. You say administrator, company name. You can make up the company. You can say ImpactTek. United States. And then username, okay? So the username, you have the opportunity to design your username. So it has to be at something.com, right? So I'm going to say
tech.org. Okay. I'm sorry. Yeah. For the role, did you click administrator?
Yep.
Okay. Thank you.
Yep. And then sign me up. Inshallah. So it might take a minute here. Have access to your email because it's going to ask you to verify it. Awesome. Almost. Yeah. See, please check your email to confirm your account. So now I got to go to my email. So I have a lot of emails. So let me go to this one. Oh man, they make it so complicated just to log into your email these. All right, so 7-7-7-3-0. Okay, so I haven't received the email just quite yet. Let me know when you guys have received it. Has anybody received the confirmation email?
No, I got a little. It was
not yet. Okay. But I'm just going to give you an idea, okay? So when you go in, right, there's a couple buttons I want you guys to look at, right? This is probably the most important button in Salesforce. It's called setup button, right? So every time you do something new, you want to click on setup, and it'll take you back to your homepage, okay? So go ahead and do that. So it'll take you back to this page. And then on this left side, right, whatever you want, for example, if you want like whatever you want to find, like app manager, right? You just type it in here. You type in the quick find, and it's gonna show up, right? So we're gonna click on app manager to create a new app, right? But I want you guys to have an idea of what apps are, right? So I want you to type app launcher. So it should be app manager app. Click on the app launcher right here. You see this, app launcher, okay? So these are the, in Salesforce, we have two things, right? We have something called custom and we have something called standard, right? Standard is everything that Salesforce comes with, right? So all these right here are all standard apps, meaning that you or a developer did not create them, right? This Salesforce gives it to you, right? What we're going to create is a custom app. So inshallah, we'll do that on Wednesday. But I want you to look at what like some apps that are already in Salesforce, right? So you have a sales app, right? So if you click on that, does this look familiar to what I was showing you with my organization?
Yeah.
You guys notice the similarities?
Yes.
So this is essentially what we're going to do, right? We're going to create an app and we're going to create tabs within the apps, right? So they're going to, for example, one tab might be opportunities, right? One tab might be leads, tasks, files, accounts, so on and so forth, right? So you're going to learn how to create all these. You're going to learn how to create all these. And within that, what else you're going to learn is how to create the fields, right? So within the tab, you have fields, right? So within opportunities, you have opportunity name, you have account name, account site, stage, right? Close date. So you can create whatever you want, right? And we will do that, inshallah. Within context, right? Same idea. So these over here are called tabs or objects, okay? The ones that I'm pointing. So tab, 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 right? Tab, tab, or object. Same thing, right? Over here are called fields. Understand? Does everybody understand the difference between a tab and a field? It's very important.
Yes.
Yes.
Right? Tabs are the bigger ones, right? Are the overarching ones, right? And within tabs, you have fields. So think of it like that. Like if you were to draw a Venn diagram, right? You have the huge one. And within the Venn diagram, you have little circles or whatever you call them, right? And that's what a field is, right? The tab is the Venn diagram. And the fields are the circles within the Venn diagram. Okay. So yeah, so this is the app launcher, right? So you have standard apps and custom apps. So what's the difference between standard and custom? Anybody?
Standard is given, like it's.
Yeah, it's given by who?
Developer?
No, who is standard given by?
By Salesforce platform.
By Salesforce, right? Like, did I make this? Did you make this? Did anybody? No, right? These are all things that were already in the system, right? So like within, so these are standard, right? So once we create our apps, we're going to create one app. That's going to be a custom app because we created it, right? We're the ones that created it. Salesforce didn't give it to us, right? So just to hammer home the concept of standard versus custom, I want you guys to go back to setup. Click on setup. And I want you to click on object manager, okay? And within object manager, right? These are the objects. Are these objects custom or standard? Like for example, contact point, communication. Are these standard objects or custom objects?
Standard.
Why, brother? You're correct, but why?
Standard object.
You're correct, yeah, but why though? Why are they standard? You're correct. Do you understand why they're standard though?
No, actually, no.
Okay, so they're standard is because you or I or a developer didn't create these, right? These were already given to you by Salesforce. So once you created your account, these are the ones that Salesforce already gives it to you, right? So they give you 51 standard objects. Any other objects, you have to create yourself or the developer has to create, right? Which we will do, inshallah. So does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay. And last thing, inshallah. because inshallah I want to we'll create the app, we'll learn about tabs and S objects and all that stuff on Wednesday, and we'll create it on Wednesday. But just to give you an idea of how to create an app, so I want you guys again go back to setup. Brother, were you able to, inshallah, were you able to get the email to verify you?
Yes, I'm already here with you guys, yeah.
Okay, alhamdulillah. So starting on Wednesday, this is what we're going to do, right? We're going to click on, we're going to go here. We're going to type in app, the app manager, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And again, these are all the apps that are currently in the system, right? Again, are these standard apps or custom apps?
This is custom apps.
You sure?
No, I'm sorry. Standard apps. I have
standard apps, right?
Items, yeah.
Yep, the one Salesforce.
Yeah.
Give. All right. So what we're going to do is we're going to click on new Lightning app. So, and then inshallah, we'll create our app and you'll see how it'll look from here to something like, so I'm going to say no for now, Oh, sorry. Confirm. Yeah. You'll see how it looks like something basic.
Mm-hmm.
Into something like this.
Marketing.
Yeah. It'll look like something like this. We'll have different tabs, and within the tabs, we'll have S objects. So inshallah, we'll do that on Wednesday. But I want you, now that you have an idea of how it works, right? This is an app, and we'll make something similar to this. You'll see it. It's very easy, very user-friendly.